Welcome to the last talk on this room today. So after Rahul finishes, we will all move to the big room. Rahul is going to talk us about student programs and how it's amazing or not, and what's stuff.
So my name is Rahul. Basically, I've been involved with Akademy with G Company software. I've developed one of the activities, and after that, I've also mentored Google Coding. So I'll be talking about how mentoring student programs can take place and how you could actually contribute in that. So the same. There's information about me. So basically, I'm a backend developer. I've been with web stuff only, like applications or websites, things like that. I'm a mathematics and computing undergrad right now, and I like to contribute free open source software and data science also. So, and apart from that, I only play football. So. I suck at FIFA, but I'm very good at football. Okay, so KD student program. So basically, there are three student programs that KD has. One is Google Coding, one is Seasons of KD, and the last one is Google Summer of Code. So basically, I was involved in mentoring Google Coding, so I'll be talking about this in length and give you an introduction of the other two programs as well. So basically, why mentor? So I started mentoring because there were two main reasons. One was as soon as I was learning open source stuff, I wanted to share my knowledge. And the second thing was I used to get to know more stuff, technical stuff, because if someone is going to ask me some question, I don't know, so I have to look up and basically help that guy. So that was basically increasing my knowledge only. So basically, this was one of the main reasons why I started to mentor. And making a decision to mentor is same as contributing to KD. You do it for the other people and for the community. Okay, so basically, these are two questions that you have to ask yourself before you actually try to mentor. What about time and effort? So basically, talk about Google Coding. Google Coding is a student program for students in high school from age 13 to 17. So basically, what happens is that the open source organization makes different tasks that you have to complete, that the student takes and completes and submits the patch or its commit to the community, right? And for the season of KD and this Google Summer Code, these are code intensive programs because mostly we see the graduate, the undergrads coming for this program, and the Google Summer of Code is paid, you get paid in stipends, so for the code that you basically contribute. In season of KD, you get a t-shirt. But both are equally code intensive.
Okay. You get a certificate too.
Yeah, you get a certificate too. Okay, so for Google Coding, as I said, the age is between 13 to 17. And bite-sized tasks is what is written on the main website. So bite-sized tasks could be you want to change, make some changes in the graphics. You want some a little code to be changed. You want the students to deploy your code onto his machine. Like very small tasks, because those children, you have to keep in mind that either they have just started learning to code, or they are good at coding but they have, haven't basically moved into open source. So that's why these are bite-sized tasks, not big tasks. This year we had 96 different tasks, and we had students that were attending around 30%, 40% tasks, And the time is around 2 months. It starts in October, but the coding begins at the end of October to January mid, January 15. So it's about 2 months. Now, basically, I just talked about what kind of tasks I was talking about. I left two of them, like bug reports. So basically, we also give tasks like you can try out our software, and you find some kind of problems, just make a bug report. You can also solve the bug, when you want, you have made some software and you want GCompute to be known around the world, right? So what do you do? You need blog posts about it, you need videos about it. So these are also kind of tasks that we give to the Google coding students. And reviews also, that's very important. Some of the tasks that are not included are like translation tasks. We don't consider them for Google coding. Now, basically, where can we improve? So these are all my personal opinions, how we could improve. Each and every project that we have here can have these bite-sized tasks. What happened last year was we had 2 to 3 days left for submission, and we had we did not have minimum number of tasks. So that shouldn't have happened. We should already have had those tasks in place, because you don't have to be a mentor to actually give a task. You can basically give those tasks to the project manager, and he can forward it. So every developer that he thinks his project can take, or graphics that can be improved, that he thinks that will help his code as well, can be also made as a task. And can be given to the project manager. Yeah. So after that, we have asked appropriate student developers to mentor, so that project head and other can help with code index stuff. So basically, most of the project managers are doing their full-time jobs and also contributing heavily to the code base as well. So this program is something that can easily be mentored by a student who has been contributing for 2 months. So because these tasks are very small, so what I personally think is the student developer should be the one mentoring these tasks, and they should and eventually the project manager can also take a look at it. But this should probably be done by a student developer, so that the season of KD, that is accorded intensive task that I mentioned, and sum of code. These are kind of continuous in with 1 month period gap. So basically they have to work on that and this as well, so that becomes hectic for them. Our project manager for GCompre was the only guy who was actually mentoring at that time, so it became hectic. I did help with the Google coding, so that gave him some wiggle room. The volume area, the only type of questions that we see those people asking are very small. They could probably be answered in a minute or 2 minutes. It's just about availability and your enthusiasm as well. Because if you don't reply them in a kind way, I would say, because they might be moved towards other projects, because there are many tasks. We are not the only organization, but actually mentoring their secondary organizations last time or more. Okay, so keeping students interested is not a responsibility, but basically when we just have to keep in mind how we're talking to them. So and tell them what interesting stuff as well, what the community is doing or what they would check out, or also I'll talk about this in the future slide. Okay, so at the end of the program, when Google coding ended, so now just the program was ending, so what our task should be is to tell them about our future student program, season of KD, right? Season of KD is for undergrad. So undergrad, it can be done by anyone, but basically undergrads are the one that actually do. So we should communicate that as well. Plus Google Summer of Code, because they might not, they might know and they might not know as well. This year we had the two winners of KD Google Core were Ilya and Sergey. And Ilya was one of the guy who actually did most of the tasks, including some code tasks as well. Plus, that guy is preparing an open source project of his own. And he also talked to us about whether we could take it into KDE and stuff. So this is pretty interesting. Like, if you could get even three or four guys interested to for being a kind of long time contributor or being interested in contributing, it's a win, right? And so let's move to the other one. No problem. So I forgot your name.
Jonathan.
Yeah. So Jonathan actually talked about Docker today. So I would add to that. Docker is something that will actually solve the problem of can solve the problem for Google Coding students. One of the biggest problems is for them to set up the project. Now, setting up the project is an important part of the being a developer, learning to code, and it is a tough part as well sometimes. So what we can do is we can make Docker images. I haven't got around to make one for G-Company, but what we do is we can make Docker setup for the application, and then the only work that is left is basically 2 to 3 commands that will basically set up your project, and the student can actually focus on the code part, because then he only has to deal with QML and C++, which he might have been already exposed to, but not to bash and shell scripting or thinking about what cmake is doing wrong or environment variables and all things, which are important, but if you want them to try the code intelligence task, this is something we can do. Plus, we do have these bite-sized tasks for setting up the project as well, because it can be tough, right? And we help all the time, but we can put Docker in Docker setups. I think that would help us to get the code typing, the code contributed as well. Second thing is collection of resources made for collaboration with fellow developers. So basically when we get new developers, if you're getting a student in Google Coden, I definitely tell you that that guy has already been exposed to some kind of programming language. So what he actually needs is a collection of resources, some blog posts that even we read when we started coding, right? So we do have some of the information on our websites, but I think as these guys are 30 to 17 years of age, we can cut them some slack and give them some resources. All these student developers can do that, because they all have some kind of bookmarks stored in their browsers. So this is something that we can solve, and in future we might have more developers trying more code tasks. We had lots of graphic tasks done this time in G-Company, all the logos, the layouts. Ilya actually made one of the activities. He didn't do much coding in there, but he had to actually set up the project and change some code, but it wasn't that code intensive. But I can't compare it, because I was 22 when I started coding, so can't actually think about whether it was tough or not. Okay, so about season of KDE. So season of KDE is just like GSOC, just and but you get a t-shirt and certificate. The problem that I felt was it is a 2-3 months long haul, right? And the project managers mostly are the ones who are actually entering these programs. So what happens is the season of KDE and Google Coding are mostly at the same time. So as I said, student developers should take on the Google Coding so that they can actually focus on the season of KD. And even for season of KD, what I felt was this time for G Company only, we had three students and one mentor. So one or two mentor, but that was that actually was problematic because these are code intensive. Like you have to give reviews, you have to give reviews on the UI itself, on code separate. Then the guy gets that the review has been done, then he makes changes, and within the night he'll just send him a comment that I made some changes. Please look at it, which is not always possible. So this is a little bit slow process. So basically, I think we should have less. I would say adequate number of students in that, and one of them is that all the three guys that actually took G Compre in their proposal, they said that we'll be doing two activities, which is more than enough. I think we should also care about what kind of task we're giving them and whether it can be completed along with the number of mentors that we have, because the mentors also have to look at code in as well. So this is something we can look at. Okay, so this is basically the end of it. I don't have much to say about dual summer of code. Dual summer of code is more competitive because you have all the people around the world competing for it, and it pays a hell of a good stipend as well. So what is basically a requirement is you have to contribute before, because mostly KD, if we see KD takes developers who have been previously contributing to code, and it is pretty intensive because the money is involved, and we kind of try to guarantee that we get the project done. So rather than tell you much better than I can, like explain much better than I can, so I'll end it here. Thank you, and any suggestions or questions?
We have one microphone, so I'll run.
I was not aware that there were three students for one mentor. I would not have allowed that. However, the mentor should have not allowed that. Right?
I think there were two mentors, I'm sure there were two mentors, but even with that, I think even Johnny told me that I'm handling this and this, so could you focus on the coding? So it was my winter vacation, so I pitched in a little and mentored.
I assume that three were accepted, assuming that one would drop out, but
yeah, that's me came in, yeah. And I think the result was that they passed, but only one of them, Divim, I would say, was the one whose project was 90% completed, because this project was would be completed only if we had translations, if we had graphics, and so that takes time. So, but his part of the code, I think, was very much complete. But the other two projects, I don't think they were as complete as they should have been, because I had already made an activity by then, so that's the reason I mentored for this as well. I had done very little bit in scene of KD, I used to just check the code and give a review as well. So add a little amount of information about what was going on at that time. So I think it was overwhelming for Johnny as well to take three students at the time. If you are a community, I don't think so, you would like to say no to students who are willing to participate. So that's a dilemma as well.
I have a question. So you were a Google coding mentor.
Yeah.
How do you feel like the output of it was versus the work you put on it? Because sometimes you put some time and you think maybe I could have done this in fewer time.
Yeah.
I don't know.
First thing, in relation to Google coding, it doesn't take much of a time. Like, it's really meant that it really takes too much time, because I don't think so. As these 13 to 17 years, students would actually talk too much if they don't have to. Second thing is, they have very small doubts. They might have long, but if they are built problems. So, other than that, it didn't take much of my time. Like, did mentor like 45, around 80% of the time I was the only guy who was mentoring, because Johnny was actually focusing on this season of KD, and he did, he was always available though, but it didn't take much of my time. Like, I was always up at night, so it was like I just used to give answer to a message. Like, it wasn't something that I was prepared to, that this is the only thing I'm going to do. It is something, but it would be if I mentored this season of KD, because you have to give in-depth review. Like, it takes a day at least if you have to give review for around like changes that have, if new features have been added. So I would like really tell student developers to patient into the Google code in.
Alright. Any more questions? No more questions.
Alright, thank you.
Thank you.